Om Namah Shivaya, students. Let us begin with part 4 of chapter 1, the rise of nationalism in Europe. In this session, we will learn about the revolutionaries, the unification of Italy 1861 and the three revolutionaries that led to the unification of Italy. 1848, the revolution of liberals and the making of Germany. And then finally, we are going to look into the assignments related to this session. The three revolutionaries, Joseph Mazzini, Count Camillo di Cavour, Joseph Garibaldi, played a very important role in the Italian unification. Joseph Mazzini led to the formation of two secret societies, the Young Italy and Young Europe, one in Marseilles, another in Berlin. Joseph Mazzini was born on 22nd June 1807 in a middle class family. He was a patriot, Italian revolutionary, founder of Young Italy, and an important figure in liberal nationalism. He was one of the three revolutionaries who made a significant contribution in the unification of Italy. In 1830, he joined the Revolutionary Carbonari, a secret association with political purposes, for which he was arrested soon and put in jail. There he organized a new political society called Young Italy, whose basic principle was the union of several states and kingdoms into one republic, and Young Europe in Berlin. Students, here you have to note that Italy in the map as you see today was not like this earlier. It was divided into seven different kingdoms that we will discuss later on in the slide. To evoke people's reaction, Mazzini wrote several essays and voiced the injustice to the working class, such as the peasants, professionals, artists, and intellectuals. He was elected as a member of Constituent Assembly and acquired the responsibility of framing a constitution for the Roman Republic. Count Camillo di Cavour, a political leader and an Italian statesman, was born at Turin on August 1, 1810. At the age of 10, he entered the military academy at Turin. He was a significant figure in the movement towards Italian unification and the founder of the original Italian Liberal Party. He founded the Agrarian Association in 1842 and the newspaper Ris Orgimento in 1847, where he struggled to establish a constitutional monarchy. Cavour was a liberal and had faith in free trade, public right of opinion, and secular rule. So on becoming the Prime Minister of Piedmont Sardinia on November 4, 1852, Cavour strengthened the kingdom, reformed taxation, established the currency, and improved the railway system. In 1853, he supported the French and British in the Crimean War with troops in anticipation to enhance the prestige of Sardinia, Piedmont. On March 17, 1861, when Victor Emmanuel II became the King of Italy, Cavour was formally declared as the Prime Minister of Italy. Count Camillo di Cavour made considerable efforts for the creation of a modern Italy state. But unfortunately, he died only 3 months after the declaration of a united Italy on June 6, 1861. Joseph Garibaldi was an Italian who was born on 4 July 1807. He was a general patriot and republican. He contributed to the Italian unification and the creation of the Kingdom of Italy. In 1848, Garibaldi returned to Italy and commanded and fought in military campaigns that eventually led to the Italian unification. Now, unification of Italy, 1861, and the three revolutionaries. Multinational Habsburg Empire. About the Habsburg Empire, we have already learnt earlier in the previous slide. Habsburg Empire was a patchwork of the different regional and linguistic diversity of people living together under one monarch. Only one thing they have in common: they are different in their culture, religion, language, food. Only one thing was there in common, that they have a common allegiance to pay to its monarch. Italy's seven states and the rule of Italian princely house of Sardinia, Piedmont. Italy had a long history of political fragmentation. Italians were scattered over several dynastic states as well as the multinational Habsburg Empire. During the middle of the 19th century, Italy was divided into seven states, of which only one, Sardinia Piedmont, was ruled by an Italian princely house. The north was under Austrian Habsburg, the center was ruled by the Pope, and the southern regions were under the domination of Bourbon kings of Spain. Even the Italian language had not acquired one common form, and it still had many regional and local variations. The unification process was led by the three revolutionaries we have already read about: Joseph Mazzini, Count Camillo di Cavour, and Joseph Garibaldi. Joseph Mazzini, during the 1830s, sought to put together a coherent program for a unitary Italian Republic. He organized a new political society called Young Italy in Marseilles and Young Europe in Brno. The failure of revolutionary uprisings both in 1831 and 1848 meant that the responsibility now fell on Sardinia Piedmont under its ruler King Victor Emmanuel II to unify the Italian states through war. Count Camillo di Cavour now led the movement to unify the regions of Italy through a tactful diplomatic alliance with France. Engineered by Cavour, Sardinia Piedmont became successful in defeating the Austrian forces in 1859. Apart from regular troops, a large number of armed volunteers under the leadership of Joseph Garibaldi joined the fray. In 1860, they marched into South Italy and the Kingdom of Two Sicilies and succeeded in winning the support of the local peasants in order to drive out the Spanish rulers. In 1861, the process of unification of Italy was completed, and Victor Emmanuel II was proclaimed the King of United Italy. Now, this is a map showing Italy before and after unification. This is how Italy looked before unification and after unification. Now, 1848, the revolution of liberals, Germans. Now, demand for constitutionalism with national unification. In German regions, Frankfurt gatherings and draft of German constitution headed by monarchy subject to parliament. The process of unification in Germany. Nationalist feelings were widespread among middle-class Germans who in 1848 tried to unite the different regions of German Confederation into a nation-state governed by an elected parliament. This liberal initiative to nation-building was, however, repressed by the combined forces of the monarchy and the military supported by the large land owners called Junkers of Prussia. From then on, Prussia took on the leadership of the movement for the national unification. Otto von Bismarck, the chief minister of Prussia, was the architect of the German unification. He did this with the help of Prussian army and bureaucracy. There were three wars over 7 years with Austria, Denmark and France, ended in Prussian victory and completed the process of unification. In January 1871, the Prussian King William I was proclaimed German Emperor in a ceremony held at Versailles. Unification of Germany. You can see Prussia before 1866. Conquered by Prussia 1866. This is the region conquered by Prussia. Austria, Hungary, joined by German Confederation with Prussia 1867. Then South German states formed with Prussia in 1871. Now this is the region won by Prussia in the Franco Prussian War in 1871. Now 1870, Prussia defeats France at the Battle of Sedan. In 1871, Otto von Bismarck unites Prussia and the German states. This led to the unification of Germany in 1871. Now assignments to be done by you related to part 4 of the session. Number 1, explain the processes of unification of Italy and Germany in detail. Number 2, what did the concept of liberal nationalism politically emphasize during the 19th century Europe? In the next session, we will learn about strange case of Britain. Om Namah Shivaya.